Yeah. What's going on, everyone? Weekly recap number 119. I'm Jake Dunlap, CEO of Scaled. No, I'm not Brett Michaels. I know you might be confused right now. You're like, oh my gosh, is that Brett Michaels? I'm not. I'm less tan and less plastic surgery. But this was the jam. I was like 7 years old. I had no clue what the hell this guy was saying.
Now, I'm always working, saving.
What's up? Adam queuing it up in Bangkok. I love it, man. All right, everybody. If you don't know, I'm from Missouri. Yes, I was very into hair metal when I was younger. And then I completely pivoted to rap and hip hop. I don't know what happened. I was very young to be into Poison and Motley Crue, but it was like the jam. I don't know what it was. I loved it. All right, I'll tell you all a secret. If you guys want to hear a very funny story here, is right before I get into the recap, I'll tell you about the week. We'll talk about Halloween. We've got all kinds of cool shit going on at Scaled. So imagine 7-year-old Jake. Okay, 7-year-old. I go to my stepdad. I have a Motley Crue CD at the time. Okay, Motley Crue CD. I go, hey Jeff, and the song is called Girls, Girls, Girls. Okay, it's a great song, Motley Crue. It's a classic 80s hair metal anthem. Okay, and I go, Jeff, what's a menage a trois? I'm like, I look back at this. I have a 6-year-old son now. And I'm like, oh my God. Like, when is my kid going to ask me like these random ass questions? So that was like, that's like a memory that's burned in my head about hair metal, is asking my stepdad what a menage a trois was. Okay. I can't wait to be when my kid's 7 and the crazy ass shit that he's going to ask me. So, all right, everybody, weekly recap number 119. This week, go check out the video from Monday. If you didn't get a chance to see it, it was me, Todd Capone, Ryan Staley, Rob Jepson, and Lisa Palmer talking about enterprise sales. So look, if enterprise sales to me is not super, super complex, I think a lot of people make enterprise sales too complex. A lot of people worry about, you know, oh, it's big deals, it's all this stuff. But we really broke down enterprise sales. The other thing that we talked about is we talked about how to make this more interesting. Meaning most people, their sales process right now is boring as hell, right? You've got these people on Zoom, you're going through the motions. It's like Groundhog Day. So we talked about different ways to make things interesting. So make sure to go and check that out. All right, who we got joining right now? Let's see who we've got on the live stream. I see Aaron Wells in there. Aaron, what's up, Aaron? My wife just commented, said my son is watching. So now I can't wait to answer for my son. What a menage a trois is. That's going to be fantastic. Adam, Missouri, born and raised. What's up, Adam? I was actually born in Iowa. Don't hate. I can't help it. I was actually born in Iowa. Adam, queuing up in Bangkok. Aaron, I know she knows what's going on. So appreciate all of you guys joining. Again, I'll probably try to do a little bit of Q&A. Bob Layton, Bob, Chief Revenue Officer at Digital Defense. If you, my friends, are a B2B company and you are trying to get your digital security down, hit up my man, Bob. Bob, what's going on, man? Good to see you. All right, so what else happened this week? So again, make sure to check out the Monday session. I thought that that went like absolutely amazing. Again, if you're in enterprise sales, it's an absolute must. The other thing I want to talk about is sales operations, okay? Like, why is this dude who's dressed so amazing talking about sales ops? Well, we did a poll. We surveyed 167 salespeople, sales, mid-level sales leaders, and VPs of sales, and we found that almost 50% of sales teams are spending like 40% of their time, between 20 and 40% of their time on sales ops stuff. So let's do the math. If you have one rep, one salesperson, let alone 5 or 10, okay, you can do the math from here. It's not that difficult, okay, who has a $30,000 a month quota and they're spending just 15% of their time on sales ops stuff. That's that small stuff that, like, you know, I built a report, I did whatever. That's over $50,000 in revenue or quota attainment every single year.
right? So therefore, if you have 10 reps, that's $500,000. You do the math from there. We're spending too much time with reps in sales ops activities. I'm telling you, it is one of the biggest opportunities you have to hire additional headcount, hire us. We do sales ops as a service because the data just shows that when reps can be more productive, they're making more money. It's kind of obvious, right? Today, we're doing a virtual happy hour. We've got a little virtual Halloween party. You can tell what your boy's going as right now. My inspiration. Hold on a second. Let me see if I can get you guys like the full look here. I don't know. Let me see what we got here. Yeah, I mean, like I went all out. Like I've got like, I went and got like extra jeans. Like I went all out for this thing. Okay. All right. That's what I did. All right. I went all out for all of you. Right. Even though you don't see the pants, right? That's what I called it. I coined this phrase in the beginning of quarantine. It's called the quarantine mullet, which is business on top, shorts on the bottom, right? No quarantine mullet here, full on 80s rock, ready to rock and roll, ready to get it done. Okay. All right. So this week in the news, get your ass out and vote. Texas, and I just want to shout out to my people at Austin. I live in Austin now, if you don't know. Shout out to all my people in Austin. Travis County has now surpassed all of 2016 voting just in early voting, which is so awesome. I love living in Austin. We moved here from New York. I love New York. We lived in Brooklyn for 5 years before here. I love Brooklyn. I love everything about it, but it's so awesome. I love living here in Austin, seeing people getting out, representing, voting. Also a couple other things. We got a full moon tomorrow night. Ooh, and an extra hour of sleep. Can you believe that? We got a full moon, extra hour of sleep. This is fantastic, right? So make sure you check that out. Accenture acquired, a B2B sales firm called N3. Again, and let me tell you why I think this is important. Shelby will drop the link for this article. So in the news, you know, again, each week we try to pull out some interesting stuff and things that are happening in the news. They acquired this company. This company has 2,200 employees, okay? The future of work is outsource people, okay? It's why I'm so bullish about running a consulting company is that people want flexibility. People want to be able to flex up and down. It used to be in sales, we would just hire all these people full time. And now I think what you're going to see is you're going to have a full time core and a lot of peripheral people because you can just get experts that are like boom, 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 experts at the little stuff. So go check that article out. And again, I want you to think about that. Like, are you future proofing your career? Are you thinking about hiring remote? Things like that. I skipped Jake's take. I'm sorry. Okay. Jake's take this week is actually a favorite one of mine. Hold on. Let me get a little extra. Let me get a little something rocking and rolling here. Oh, this is another Jake anthem back in the day. Let's get this. Give a hand clap if you've ever seen Bon Jovi in concert. I've seen all of these people in concert. Get to the hooks. Let's get to the hooks. Let's try to get to the hooks.
We got each other, and that's a lot for love. We'll give it a shot. Oh, we're halfway there.
Even if you weren't born in the 80s, even if you weren't, I'm like the edge of millennial. 1980 is like, some people say it's 81 it starts. I don't know. But I'm telling you, if you don't know Living on a Prayer, that used to be a Jake go-to karaoke jam, okay? What I would do is I would get a chair on stage, okay? I'm not kidding. I used to do this. Imagine like 26-year-old Jake in Phoenix, Arizona, you know, at some karaoke bar. I get a chair on stage and then I get up and I ninja kick and I just kick it over like right when Living on a Prayer hit or like, what was the other one? There was another Bon Jovi song. But I'm telling you, if you get up on stage, you pull a chair up on stage at a karaoke bar, I'm telling you, and then you kick it over, You bring down the house. I'm just warning you. Brett Parsons. What's up, Brett Parsons? Brett and I went to high school together. Brett, I don't know if, well, you probably don't know this. Me and my buddy Brandon Fernell, okay, this is in 2000. I was in college, so it would have been like 2000, 2001. We went to the Poison, Rat, and Cinderella concert. This is one of my best sales. This is when I knew I was destined to be in sales, okay? So let me just tell you what it was. So they had a deal. If you had the best banner, you could get backstage. So me and Brandon Fernell, we were crushing like Zimas or Smirnoff Ices or something like that. So we go to this Poison concert. We make a banner. We obviously don't win. We're like two 20-year-old dudes, okay? Brandon and I at one point, I had a wife beater on. I'm pretty sure I threw it into the crowd. I didn't even have a shirt. I'm like wrapped in this banner at this point. And I'm like, dude, we're going backstage, okay? I'm like, we're getting back there, okay? Probably one of the best sales moments of my life. So we go back to where the backstage area is. There's this big gate. This is in Kansas City. It's at, oh gosh, what's the name of the theater there? Brett, you'll probably remember. What's that? There's like an outdoor theater there that like where they do plays and stuff. So Brett maybe can drop it. If you're from Kansas City, you know what I'm talking about. So there's this like wooden thing. And there's a guy here who's letting people backstage. So all these people were in line that already had passes. So what happened, I see these people getting in. This guy turns around and walks this way. I jump in line in between these two people. I'm like, Brandon, get in here. So we get halfway down this hill. Keep in mind, I've thrown my, I'm wrapped in a Poison and like 98.9 Rocks Starlight. That's it, Brett. I'm wrapped in a banner. We get halfway down this hill. This dude, he finally turns around. He goes, what are you doing? I go, dude, we got to get backstage. He goes, okay. And the guy led us backstage. Myself and Brandon Fernell, we got to meet CeCe DeVille, Bobby Dahl. We didn't get to meet Brett Michaels and Ricky Rocket. So that is when I got a chance to meet Poison because I just jumped in line. That's life. That's my, you know, that's Jake's take. Okay. Stop playing it safe. Just jump in line. Half the time people are like, yeah, that's cool. If I never would have done that, right? I never would have had as Brandon Fleury, my strawberry Zimas. Yeah, it's Brandon. No, not in the 80s. It was the 2000s. You put the Jolly Rancher in the Zima, right? You go to a Poison concert. You'd rock out. All right. So that's my Jake's take, right? Jump in line. Cut the line. Stop waiting for some opportunity to come. It's never going to happen. They didn't pick my banner. I don't give a shit. I'm still getting backstage. I'm meeting my man CeCe DeVille. I'm meeting Bobby Dahl. I'm meeting Ricky Rocket. If you don't know who those people are, this is Ricky Rocket. This is Bobby Dahl. And this is CeCe DeVille, one of the greatest guitarists of all time. Okay. I'm not kidding. CeCe DeVille is one of the greatest guitarists of all time. But another great Bon Jovi one too.
Sometimes I sleep. Sometimes it's not for days.
All right, ask Jake anything. Two quick questions here every week. I take your questions as many as I can. If you haven't signed up yet, hold on. Shelby, I know you're on here, but I'm gonna drop it in here. So I created, this is the first ever, I was approved. I'm one of like a very, very small handful of people. Okay, text this number right now. If you text this number, it goes straight to my phone. Gary Vaynerchuk, Jennifer Lopez, Ninja, Ellen DeGeneres, you name it. I was approved to start the first sales and leadership community on Community. It's called Community. So if you guys have questions, if you guys are like, Jake, I've got some random thought, just text that number I just dropped. It literally goes straight to my phone. It's one-to-one. This is not a like AI or a bot or anything. It's pretty awesome, man. I'm telling you, the questions that people ask, there's something about text message where the questions that people ask whenever it's text is so much deeper. And I've really, really enjoyed it. People asking questions about their career, maybe things that they'd be scared to put in a DM, but text feels more comfortable. So go and text this number right now. The community is growing really quickly. I just launched this on Tuesday. So Jacob Westrom is an Iowa native. What's up, Jacob? I was born. Shout out to you, Jacob. There's absolutely no chance that you know this. But I was born in a town called Premgar, Iowa. You know what? Holy shit. I might even have it because I just got my Texas license. Hold on. If you know, I've got a lot of friends on here I can see right now. So if you don't know, okay, so Premgar, Iowa. Let me show you what my birth certificate looks like. Okay, born in Iowa, right, representing. This is not a joke, people. This is my actual birth certificate, okay? Look at this thing. It looks like it belongs in a museum, okay? This thing is like on a typewriter. It's got like yellow around the edges. Premgar, Iowa, just so you know, has 900 people. Oh, mic turned down. Okay, there we go. All right, we're back. Shelby said the mic turned down. I think we're okay now. We can still hear you clearly, but your audio just got a lot quieter. Okay, all right, I think we're back. All right, so this is what's up. Premgar, Iowa. This is what a rural Iowa birth certificate looks like, if you guys are wondering. Okay. So anyway, back to Jake's, let's see, Ask Jake Anything. Okay. By the way, I did hear a new potential name for it, which was, what was it? Becca came up with it. I'll get back to it. It was pretty funny. All right. So this week's Ask Jake Anything, I think my volume's back. If there's any issues, just let me know. Is there any hack to enterprise contracts paperwork? Is there any hack to, or are we doomed to sit and wait with little to no control over the situation? So here's my hack for if you're trying to close big deals, enterprise paperwork. Start the process early. What I've always been very successful, if it's a big deal, after I walk somebody through the proposal process, I immediately send them the contract. Now, I don't send them the contract with the deals. I say, look, it seems like I know that this might take a little bit of time. Let me send you the contract so we can start the red line process, and then we'll go from there. So that's my hack there. Next question from my boy, James Mackey. What's up, James Mackey? I'm going to talk to you in a minute, man. I hope you're doing amazing. James Mackey, shout out, running an amazing recruitment firm. What is the best time to post and engage with executive sales leaders? Sales leaders are on LinkedIn pretty much 24/7, but I would say early morning. Early morning, 8 o'clock, et cetera. All right, so last but not least, I'm gonna send you all home with some just 80s bangers here. Last but not least, I wanna find like a perfect song. Oh, hold on, no, yes. Oh, this is another one. I don't know if this is technically 80s though. Let's see if this one was like technically 80. Like the intro is so long. You can't do an 80s without talking about my boy Axel, you know? I'm telling you, November Rain might be the best of the best of hair metal. November Rain might go down as the best of the best, but we'll end it on something a little more upbeat. So next week, everyone, let's see. I've got Monday, Jake and Friends. Always make sure you check that out, 12 o'clock Eastern. It's going to be amazing. Do that. The other big piece is 2021 planning. We are knee deep in 2021 planning. Here's my best advice. We did an exercise this week for the first time. It's called the 12-quarter plan. So what we're doing now every single quarter is we're working backward 12 quarters. So 3 years. We're always looking 3 years out, 3 years out, 3 years out. So think about your career that way. Think about your company that way. That's on the docket for this week. So that, my friends, it's been a little all over the place. It's Halloween. I just started my coffee. All right. I hope all of you have an amazing weekend. Make sure to tune in this coming week, Jake and Friends. 12 o'clock Eastern on Monday. It's always amazing. We usually get a few hundred people that show up. Have a great Halloween. Be safe. Wear your mask. If you are going to, I don't think people are trick-or-treating this year, but if you are, wear your mask. And have a great, amazing weekend. Have so much fun. Stay on. If you haven't noticed, I've been doing a little Easter egg, okay? If you just stay on for a little bit, it's 8:52. Your next meeting doesn't start for 8 minutes. I'm going to turn back on the music. I'll turn back on the music. And we'll have a little fun. All right, everybody. That, my friend, is weekly recap number 119. I am out.